Everybody, welcome to another Rock My Bean with me and my stepson Mark here, who is reacting to the sounds of bands of the classic rock era, particularly the 70s and 80s. And he's a Gen Z guy, so a lot of times it's the first time he's ever heard this. And Mark, we've been doing Rush and Led Zeppelin and Pink Floyd and ABBA. Well, today we're going to be doing Rush again. And we're going to be doing the last song that we've reviewed all the songs in this album now, called Moving Pictures. And this was, I think, the seminal album for Rush. Literally was, I think, their greatest album. Just a perfect album all the way around. And every song in this album was just so good. And this song, Vital Signs, is probably the most overlooked sign on the album. A song on the album. And it's it's really about... The whole song is about maintaining, being true to oneself in the face of a changing world and all the problems that come with living in this world. And that's essentially what Neil Peart was trying to get through. But the music is really reminiscent of this period of rock music, where you had bands like The Police and others. Rush really tried to nail the sound, this frenetic reggae, progressive electronica sound that was becoming popular in the late 70s, early 1980s. And this song, I think, was the song that kicked off Rush's foray into the next album, which was Signals, and, you know, and Grace Under Pressure, and Power Windows, and those next three albums in the 80s, which were very electronic oriented. And this song off this album was a kind of a key where they were going with their next four albums. But this song is overlooked a lot, and so I wanted to do it because it's really a fantastic song. It's unlike the other songs on the album in that it's very electronic, but Alex's guitar is very much like you were hearing from The Police and other bands at the time, and Neil's drum part is just outstanding in this. So you ready to hear Vital Signs?
Yes.
Okay, this is the official video, Vital Signs on Vivo. This came out on MTV. In, I think, 1980, when the song and the album came out. So
MTV
was brand new at the time. So are you ready?
Yes.
Vital Signs.
Let's listen now.
What's whistling in? Here we go. Ready? 3, 2, 1.
Go.
Hit it.
Some
Thank you, Raj. Viral Signs. It was a really good song. Sorry, I'm sounding like this because of the voice.
That's okay.
And,
What'd you think?
I really love the drumming. I really loved it.
Was that good?
Yeah, the drumming was... Neil was just amazing.
He knows when to put in a big fill.
He
breaks the bar all the time.
Yeah, he knows how to do this. I wish I could play like this.
You know, it took him a long time to do that, and it takes a long time for you to do that, but you're doing good, and you'll get there if you keep at it. Keep at your practice.
Yeah.
You'll have it one day.
Yeah, it's just so amazing that Rush is going through those kind of subjects.
You know, I want to say something about the drumming.
Yeah.
It's nice to have a bar so high that you have to aim for rather than something low. And Neil's about as high as it gets. So if you can get over Neil's bar, you know you've become a great drummer. Even if you aren't out on the stage
with
thousands of people, you know you've done it. So for me, that was the challenge. I remember it was going to be out. I played for hundreds of people, but never thousands.
Yeah.
Maybe one time, but it was close. But never a big, big like he did. But if I can play his part the way he did it, and play it the way as well as he did, I know that I have accomplished something as a drummer. So for me, that was like, pat on my own back. I worked hard to get there.
Yeah.
And so you may never play for thousands of people, but if you can play his songs, you know you've achieved something. It gives you something to aim for.
Yeah.
Okay, so now about the subjects.
I really love the subject of this song. Yeah. I really love the subject that is kind of more like fantasy. In it is more science fiction in it.
Not well.
Because was Neil having a dream about this, or somebody encouraged him to?
Well, this song is about trying to, as I said before the video, trying to stay true to yourself, to who you are.
Yeah.
And your character and what you think is important to be yourself.
Yeah.
In the face of the changing world, and the problems that come with living.
Oh, I understand.
And the conflicts.
So
so basically, that was what Neil was writing about, because the world's always been going through difficult times.
Yeah.
I think in their time it's the worst, but the last generation thought they were the worst. But we all go through worse times of some
kind,
and we all face challenges to who we are and what we believe, and trying to stay true to who we are. In the face of cultural changes and technological changes, economic challenges, a global war and conflict and everything else, we're always trying to stay true to ourselves. And that's what he was talking about. In very highbrow language, in fact. But Neil was a voracious reader, and so he wrote the things he read, and he wrote like those he read. So he had a huge vocabulary, and he also knew how, at the heart of a poet, he knew how to write those words in a poetic fashion that really just resonate with the listener.
Yeah.
Everybody has to elevate from the norm. Everybody's got to deviate from the norm. That's a solution for trying not to get stuck in the norm and becoming a monotonous society that's locked into nothing but trouble. But anyway, I loved his use of language. It always hit home with me, would speak to me and talk to me and tell me, man, this is how I got to think about this.
Yeah.
He did the thinking for me in a sense. He came up with the words I need to use to think about this this particular subject.
Yeah.
So yes, it wasn't a science fiction, although he did a lot of science fiction stuff. This wasn't fiction. This was actually just his feelings about life in general.
Oh, so this is about his like a personality.
Yeah, what it was like to try to live in a changing world and stay true to who you are and what you believe.
Yeah.
We all have to do that to some extent if we have beliefs. Some people go through life with no beliefs at all.
Yeah.
When we have beliefs, you have principles, trying to stick with them can be a challenge, and he presents that in this song.
Of course.
This is the last song on the record. It's the very last song. And a lot of people thought it was a filler, but believe me, this song was not a filler. You can hear Alex Lifeson playing the reggae guitar, like that.
Yeah.
But Neil and Geddy were not playing it. They were playing a different rhythm altogether, which kept it from becoming a reggae song. Even though Alex was playing that, playing that reggae guitar.
Yeah.
And then there was that keyboard in the background.
Sound.
So it was a brilliant song. And it's too bad that it gets forgotten in all the other great songs on the album.
Yeah.
But I love playing drums to this song. This is a fun song to play drums to.
Yeah. Just like I mentioned when I was doing Queen, We Are the Champions. It's overdone song,
yeah.
But lots of people like it.
Lots of people like it. And this song has not been overdone. It's been underdone. I mean, it's like the last song on the record, and just kind of all we just used to fill the record. But they didn't. This was a really great song. Well composed, well engineered, really well done music, instrumentally. These guys were just such brilliant musicians and a great band. And they never, I mean, this album is their best album for a reason. Their best songs are on this album.
Of course.
And there are no sleepers. And this one is not a sleeper.
No sleepers.
Yeah,
no.
Songs that people just ignore because they had to just lay there. This album didn't have any of that. And
no.
Not too many groups in the last 30 years have albums that have every song is just killer.
Yeah.
There are a handful of bands I can name that did. Rush was one. Boston was another. There's other bands that had songs, albums like that, where the whole album is just totally great. And, you know, you almost never get to do that again. It almost never happens twice. But
Fleetwood
Rush,
Mac had Sluts on the
Yes, buses. They had
Blondie.
Well, I don't know about Blondie, but Fleetwood Mac had Rumors. It was also a fantastic. They did that. So it does happen to great bands, but only once, usually. Rush, however, had a lot of success. Well, this is their greatest album.
Yeah.
I like almost all their albums, almost equally. And not everyone, but almost all of them.
Yeah.
And every song on this album is, though, great. And we have now done all the songs on Moving Pictures.
Yeah.
We had to, because every song on here is great.
Yeah.
So, 10 being the best Rush songs, 1 being the worst.
I'm going with the 10.
You're going with the 10. Well, yeah. Okay, very good, Mark.
With everything.
High five on that one.
Because of everything, what is in the song. The subject, the drumming,
okay.
The singing, the guitar playing, everything is very cool. I mean, I really into Queen more.
That's all right. That's fine. We all have our favorites, but you do appreciate what you just heard.
Yeah.
And you appreciate what Rush did and put on this album.
Yeah.
You know, every song isn't going to be a hit, but if you appreciate for what they did on this, then mission accomplished.
Yeah.
Because it is a fantastic song in its own right. It just deserves more respect. But those of us who are drummers and musicians, I believe we respect it.
Yeah.
Because we know what it went to.
Of course.
And the musician too.
Yeah.
That's why you recognize it.
Yeah, I understand because and my stepfather really loves this music.
That would be
and
me.
But I really love pop, pop, especially the band Queen, because for me, Freddie Mercury is really into me.
That's great. Like, I mean, that was a brilliant band with a brilliant singer.
Yeah.
Now, this song, you could actually dance to it. Believe it or not, you could. It's probably the only Rush song I know of that you could actually dance to. In the early 80s, it had that poppy electronica sound that was very popular in the early 80s. It became more popular after the song came out.
You think I should do that in a song in my channel?
You want to try it and see what happens. See if they get any likes on it, because you can dance to it. It does work, I mean, if you wanted to.
Yeah.
Most Rush songs you couldn't dance to if you tried.
Especially Tom Sawyer.
Yeah, especially all of them. But this one here is unusual.
Yeah.
All right. That's all I have to say. I'm going to give this one a 9. It's not a 10 in my book. It's really good. It's not a 10, but it's a 9, and it deserves a 9. It's a golden 9. So that's what I'm giving it. And because it is such a great song all by itself, it's just unfortunate that it's packaged with a bunch of other incredibly great songs, and it kind of gets lost in the mix.
Yeah.
If it was on another album, it would be raised at a higher level, I think, because it'd be no notice, but being on a record, it's already got greats, really, you know, a lot of tens on it. A 9 is going to kind of fall back into the behind the rest. So, but anyway, that's our thoughts on Vital Signs. We've done the entire Moving Pictures album. Now, thank you for joining us for this Rush reaction. And Mark's getting into Rush. He's not his favorite band, but he is understanding it and appreciating it.
I'm more into Queen.
Right, but he doesn't dislike it. And so, you know, we got to expose these young people to this music or it will disappear. We have to do that.
We'll disappear. We'll vanish.
Go away. So, because the music industry doesn't make any money on old music. They make it on new stuff.
Yeah.
They don't make money on this stuff. So they don't want you to hear it because they don't make a dime on it.
That much.
They want to sell you a bunch of garbage and get everybody to listen to it. They've been doing that for a long time. And unfortunately, people will swallow garbage if they're told to. But there's a lot of great diamonds in the rough in here. And, you know, a lot of great music in the past that needs to be brought back to this new generation. And a lot of when they hear it, they do like it. But they've got to hear it. They've got to be exposed to it. And I'm talking about usually beyond teenage years. And they'll say, man, I can't believe I went my whole life and didn't hear this. A lot of them say that. So it's important that we on this channel are doing that. I'm doing it to you, and we're doing it to those that are listening to us. All right, Mark. Remember to check out Mark's DJ 2000 channel. The link is below.
And, I did all the videos today.
He did a ton of videos for his channel. We are reacting to Rush, of course, ABBA, Led Zeppelin, and Pink Floyd. So get over there and check those out. Please like and subscribe. We need subscribers, and share it with family and friends, because the algorithm is not getting us out. It's intentionally shadow banning us, and I have no idea why, but they hate their customers.
Yeah.
So other than that, so you need to help us. Please help us out. And Mark, say goodbye.
See you later.
Remember to keep smiling, stay happy,
and keep rocking on.